Hello guys, Lucy from Brintech Customs. On this episode, we want to show you guys the cooling system. So what we've done with it. We're on the home run now, so hopefully stick with us and we should see it running soon. Alright guys, so we've done the cooling header tank, which is going on this side here. As you can see there on the strut tower right there, that links onto straight onto the factory inlet there. That's where it goes on the E46 M3. Okay, so we've got our top breather here that goes, it's got to go all the way to here. Okay, we'll do that later. So I want to show you guys what we've done here with the heater lines. So as you can see, these two pipes here coming out of the from the heater box, I've had to just readjust them slightly because with the M3 intake box, it gets in the way. So as you can see, I'll show you guys here. Give me a sec. Okay, trying to get some good light in there. Okay, so this cavity here, that's where they gotta go. That's where the factory E46 M3 one is. But with the E30, once it's in there, it sits around here, which is just in the way. So we've readjusted them, and I'll show you how we've done them. Once again. Okay, so the easiest way to do this, and it's pretty easy. You got to be careful, but it's pretty easy. So if you use a socket, that'll fit nice inside there. Now this one normally points slightly up. Okay, so put a socket in there and then just hold it on this side, and then we bend it over just a little bit so it kicks more straight and a little bit towards the driver's side. And this one here, you got to kick it over just the smallest amount this way. Okay, and down. So that there is enough clearance for us to then fit. Here we've got this is the factory hose from the E46. Give me one sec. Okay, so that'll go there, and that'll fit in here. Now the other one on the M3 normally goes to the heater tap. We don't have a heater tap here, so we need this one to go to here. But if we use two of the same hose, so two lower ones, you gotta cut this factory clamp, that clamp there, you gotta cut it off, because the locator, There's a locator here in the, on the engine side. On this side, it's on the other side, so I can't show you. I'll show you on this one. And if you can see it, that it's right at the top here, okay? And that lines up with the little slots, that one right there, okay? So if I try and put this one onto there, it points down and then this hose won't line up. So if you cut that clamp off there, put this one back in. Okay, so I've cut it off and I've put a normal hose clamp in place there, and that has allowed me to twist the hose and put it back into a position. Okay, that's gone in there. That's allowed me to put it in a position so that can be fitted. Okay, so that works really well. And I've already trial fitted the airbox and we've got good clearance here. Okay, so that's the heater hoses. Now on this side, this is the temp sender for the dash, for the E30. Now the M3 uses the DME to send the signal to the instrument cluster to show you the coolant temp. Now this, the E30, it's a bit behind in that technology, so we've got to use the factory E30 temp sender. Now there's, I've done it differently before, but I find that this works best, where you can just drill and tap onto the housing and screw it on there, but you do run a bit of a risk because it's not perfectly smooth and you've got to put a washer on there, then you run a bit of more risk of having leaks. And if you undrill it straight and tap it straight, then that can be a problem as well. Now this is what we use on the M54s. The M54s, you can't even do that on this because it just doesn't work on the M54. So we stuck to this and this works pretty well. Now if you've noticed, this only has one pin. Okay, so that means that it earths through the body. Now because you're clamping it onto rubber, it's not gonna see any ground. And that's why we've added this little tab here with an earth wire that earths back onto the body. Okay, and it's just a single wire that goes onto onto this plug here. If I remember correctly, it's a brown with a white trace, I believe. Don't quote me on that, but I think that's, if I remember off the top of my head. Okay, so that single wire will go to there and that'll give you your water temp. Now you've got to use the top hose. This is where the outlet is, where the hot water is. The bottom one is the cold side. So that's our solution for our water temp. What else can I show you here? We've got the fuel filter mounted down the bottom. Got our lines going through there. We've got our charcoal canister fitted back in onto the factory switch, which is controlled by the DME on the M3. What else? I think that's it. We've got to do our oil cooler lines for the engine. We've got the adapter ready there to go. That's it, I think, for now. So we're on the home stretch now. We're getting close to starting on the wiring. Just a couple of other small things to do and we're nearly there.